you very much. The governor of Nairobi City is here. The senator of Nairobi City is here. Elected members of parliament from Nairobi are here standing in solidarity with Kenyans who wish peace for this country. We are here standing in solidarity for people who have invested in this city. We are here standing in solidarity with people who are working in this city, and standing in solidarity with people who have invested and are living in this city. Our solidarity is something that you know, is embedded in our constitution as Kenyans, that everyone has a right to express their will. And Kenyans did express their will on the 26th of October. And generally, Nairobi has been peaceful. However, in the last 2 days, the larger Dagoretti area, what was traditionally the Dagoretti constituency, before it was split into two, has been an arena of the most undesirable of events. And it is that occurrence in Dagoretti that has led these leaders to come out and say that not only are we standing in solidarity with the Kenyans who are peacefully, who are peaceful and wishing the best for this country, but we are also standing with the law. And that is why we are standing here and calling upon anyone who is feeling aggrieved not to go out and retaliate in whatever manner, because as you can see, we the leaders are leading by example. We are just coming from a meeting with the Inspector General of Police, IG Boynet, who has now assured us of full security that will be provided, and especially for the areas that have been trouble spots like Kawangware. We are being assured that there will be police security that is actually going to be beefed up. And so we are calling upon anyone who is feeling aggrieved to not come out and try and take law into their hands. Finally, I'd like to say that we as a country have bigger fish to fry after this election. There are young Kenyans, numbering over a million of them, around half a million sitting their KCPE next week. Over half a million will be sitting their KCSE. These are young Kenyans who would wish to sit for their examinations in peace. And these I use just as an example of other people who are running enterprises and businesses and who want to go on with life, because we cannot politic 365 days a year. So we are asking for those of us who are in leadership to not use young people to be the front line in a political contest where we are seeking a seat at the table by using violence. So the young people out there, we are calling upon you to be reasonable even as you take any action. Those of us who are privileged to be able to access what we are now popularly calling social media, kindly use it responsibly. There's a lot of fake news out there. There are a lot of fake reportage going on. Kindly, before you forward anything, before you press the send button, kindly verify and double verify. The case of Kawangware was a sad one, where we had incidences of matters being exaggerated and also blame being exchanged between people who are not even interested party in that issue. So we are out here standing in solidarity with all the Kenyans who would want to see peace in this city. Thank you.
Yes. I also want to share the same sentiment with my colleagues.